Hello there, this is Only One Kenobi, Only One, and welcome to this special video. I've been thinking about the barge quite a lot, and barge fever kicking in. The thing is on its way, so this was an exciting notification this week. Bam! Yeah, that's so cool to see that it's posted. That good thing about eBay is that we can track the postage and all of that, and also I've been tracking it as well. So it seems it started in California, it's made its way to Oklahoma City, it's in Illinois, it's on its way to the UK. Brilliant. So there you go. So I've been thinking about what I'm going to be putting on the barge, of course. And here is an array of loads of figures and characters that I personally want to put on the barge. And let me tell you now from the get-go, before I show you what I've chosen here, that what I've decided is I'm going to have my barge displayed not to mock up the Return of the Jedi scene, the Battle of the Pit of Carkoon. I'm going to have mine reflecting a generic period of Jabba's use of the barge. So these are a selection of aliens, bounty hunters, informers, spies, friends, even some Imperials, and that's been inspired by watching Solo recently, and even some pod racers, because Jabba loved pod racing. There's no doubt that he would have maybe, because he liked the sport, maybe invited some of his favourite pod racers to join him for a cruise, you know? Why did he use the barge? Well, to get from A to B. Maybe he just used it for tours of Tatooine so he could interact with his guests, his friends, his family, and do business. So that's what I figure. The reason I was talking about Solo and the Imperials is because on that scene, one of my favourite scenes in Solo is when you go into Dryden Voss's yacht. And there's a little cluster of Imperials. In fact, I didn't even notice it when I first watched it, but they're all on there. And it just proves the corruption of the Empire, that they are hanging around and associated with underworld characters like Crimson Dawn, Black Sun, and also the Hutt clan. There's no doubt that maybe Jabba, his power and reach goes beyond Tatooine. He was an intergalactic gangster. So that's why I like the idea of displaying Imperials in there as well. So let's have a look at all that I have on display here. I have Luke Skywalker, Jedi Knight, you know, I have these figures in my collection, but I've just decided to not go with the, that's what most people will be doing with their barge, you know. I want to kind of, as I say, have a diorama to reflect a general peacetime cruise, because it was all action on that scene, wasn't it, in Return of the Jedi. So all of these are 3¾ inch, and it would be wrong not to have this gentleman here, Mr. Bib Fortuna. This is my best version of Bib Fortuna, which is the Power of the Force one. The only other figure I have is the 80s version, which is sort of a bit old hat now, really. I don't have the Saga collection either, and I hope they don't repack that, because one thing I don't like about the vintage collection, sorry, the vintage 80s one, is that mouth. It's very nostalgic, this figure, but I just think that one was a better facial sculpt, although he looks a bit podgy there, doesn't he? He's gained a bit of weight. So all these guys, all my selection today are people who could have been on the barge, but these guys definitely have, because we've seen them on there. That's, of course, his muscle, his hired muscle, his hands, his goons, his henchmen. This is Woof, and then you've got here this gentleman, which I always thought was this guy, but no. This guy is this guy, and that's his own man, that's Vizan. That's the guy shooting his cannon onto the rebels, onto Lando and fam and everybody. This guy, you might not even see him very well in the movie. There's another guy who's coming out in the three-pack that is also who I thought was him. So there's obviously lots of Nictos that are in the Jabba family. And there are lots of Weequays. I have two on offer for you here. Unfortunately, I don't have the Vintage Collection Weequay either, but because there's so many different Weequays, there's at least three of them in Return of the Jedi. One gets chucked out of a window, one does the Wilhelm scream, and then the first one is the one who is, you know, move him into position, and he puts Luke onto the plank. So this one here is one I had him in the 80s when I was a kid. This is one I've bought since, and I always used to look at his head, and it used to remind me of Toffos. If you're from the UK, Toffos are like a toffee sweet that are in a plastic wrapper, and when you open them out of the wrapper, they look all creased, and this guy had the same colour head and the same sort of wrinkles and creases on his head that Toffos used to have, so I always used to think of him. It used to remind me of Toffos. This is a really good figure, and also, ironically, I'm using a selfie stick here, so I thought it would be smoother, but it's a bit shaky. This guy is, if it's on the card back, on the freeze frame, he is one of the most expensive figures in that line of figures. But anyway, that's a really good weak weight. Moving on, we have, of course, Kithaba, formerly known as Barada. Now, he is a skiff guard, but you know, he will go wherever Jabba tells him to go, so there's no reason why Jabba wouldn't give him a job on the deck of the Khetanna one day. So there you go, all these guys will work really nicely on the deck. They are the security of Jabba's farm, are they not? Now then, I mentioned pod races before. I just like the idea of maybe having one or two pod races, because, you know, I just imagine Jabba might be such a fan of, you know, pod racing that he would, you know, invite these guys along one day, as he admires them or whatever. So there we have, of course, Sebulba, Rats Tyrell, and Mar Hanik. I don't like using the selfie stick. I'm going to stop using it right now. Just bear with me a moment. And we're back. So this is the original design for Jabba the Hutt. This is Moseb Bined. He is Jabba the Hutt's accountant. And without question, this guy would have been on the barge at some point in his history. He is seen in the cantina. I'm just trying to get into focus. There you go. He is seen in the cantina. And also, apparently, it could be him or someone who is the same species in the background of the Jabba's palace. However, the original design for Jabba the Hutt was this guy, because he was in a comic looking like that. They got around that because when they finally designed Jabba for Return of the Jedi, they explained why he was... why he used to call himself Jabba, because apparently, because he was Jabba's associate and he was working on behalf of Jabba, he referred to himself as Jabba. But he is Moseb Bined, and it's really annoying me. I've done several takes of this. Why won't it focus? I need to get a proper camera, man. I'm getting tired of this. It's obviously focusing on the background, but there you go. I'm trying to, when you tap the screen on the target, it should focus in on him. But there you go, he's back. Back on focus. Now, ignore him for a minute. He is a not even a cantina patron. He is a Mos Eisley street dweller. Now, this guy here, I've said this a while ago, I'd love the idea of having him on the barge. He is a bounty hunter, or he's a smuggler. He's an underworld character of Tatooine. I just like the idea of him being on the barge, because he's got his little thing of milk there. It's a great figure, an underrated figure in the vintage collection. Gorgeous sculpt. And I learned about him recently that he escaped from the detention area on the Death Star, apparently, and then he ended up on Tatooine. But whoever he is, he's a criminal. He could be an entourage member as well. Just ignore him for a minute, we'll come back to him. I want to talk about this droid here. Now, as I said, I'm not going to be putting a 3PO on. I could put 3PO on, I could put Leia on it, I could put Han and everybody, but I'm going to put this droid on because this is his original, Jabba the Hutt's original interpreter droid. I don't know if it's the one he disintegrated or what, or how many droids Jabba went through, but in the Clone Wars, this guy was his droid. And I knew I had this figure, and I've dug it out especially for this video. But what I was pleasantly surprised with, because this was a Builder Droid figure from the Legacy Collection. You have to buy 6 or 7 figures, or more or less, maybe, I don't know. And then you get a piece to put together. When I got it out today, I realised that this has been done in the realistic style, which is great. I thought that they'd made him a Clone Wars figure like this. I still haven't opened this 3PO, but this is a figure that I've got. Clearly it's done in the animated style. The figure's been sculpted like the anime, because they look a little bit animated, not like real life. That's 3PO. Now, I thought this figure was like that, but it's not. I'm pleasantly surprised. So if you can let me know his name, let me know in the comments, but he is going to be next to Jabba in Jabba's boudoir, whatever you want to call it, boutique, I don't know. His room next to him. So there you go. And what else do we have? So I'm just fixing Mahonik's falling over. We've done Mahonik, we can move past. It's a little bit cliche having him on the barge, but I just thought I'd dig him out because I don't know what his businesses would have been on Tatooine, but he might know Jabba or have been part of a little clan or group, made his way on there one way or another. But this guy definitely has. This is Greedo. Now, this is one of his bounty hunters, like Fett was a bounty hunter for Jabba as well. So before he met his demise in the cantina, he would have been on the barge, without question. I mean, if he hadn't, then he wasn't invited, but he could have been. Now, speaking of cliche and bounty hunters, I've put these other ones here. I'll come to them later, but there's Bosk there. I love Bosk, and he was on the barge, by all accounts, when it blew, or at least he was in some production shots. They edited him out of the movie, obviously. So it's almost like he wasn't there, but production photographs suggest he was. But there is obviously a link between Fett and Bosk. And IG-88, who's in the background there, we'll come to him in a minute. So he could be part of the entourage, being on the barge and be on display on the barge. And so could this lady. Now, this is Aura Singh. Aura Singh also likes to watch pod racing, and she was there in Phantom Menace in the background, blinking, you miss it. But because she's a bounty hunter, there's no reason why she wouldn't have had business with Jabba. In fact, you might need to educate me there in the comments. I have seen all the Clone Wars. I might have skipped a few episodes because I watched them online. But, and I might have lost count or whatever, and fallen asleep watching an episode or something, but has she done much business with Jabba? I don't know. Let me know. But she is looks awesome, Aura Singh. I love the look of Aura Singh. And I might have her below deck on the Khetanna. All these are Jawas, and we know how they work, and they obviously will do anything to get in with anybody, won't they, really, because they're scavengers. But I've got two sets of Jawas to show you here, the Black Series ones there. And then these guys, you know, I tip my hat to the design of these, because they've aged fantastically. They're sculpted well, and they have the glow eyes as well, because they have the sunroof. So, I think you can just about see it anyway, so I just wanted it to focus. Yeah. And then, yeah, you tilt the eyes and then you can see the glow in the eye. I love that. There it is, that's a bit better to focus there. So there you go, I'll put them definitely somewhere else on there. Now, moving on, I've put these guys in because I just love the design of these guys, and would they or wouldn't they have had association with Jabba the Hutt? Well, we just don't know. But I would say yes, they would, because it's all the underworld, isn't it? It all ties in with Han Solo, Fett, and shady practices in the galaxy. Because Saw Gerrera, though he was associated with the Rebel Alliance, the Rebels actually saw him as a terrorist. You know, he was unorthodox and dangerous. So, you know, Jabba's a dangerous guy. He's got, you know, clout in the galaxy. So these guys might have at one stage approached him. So that's in the background there. You've got Empress Nest there, of course. And I don't know if this is Edrio Two Tubes or his mate, his brother. They look exactly the same. The difference is that one of them has the pilot chest there, the other doesn't. So I don't know which one is Edrio and not. But anyway, I love the design of Edrio Two Tubes. And he, you know, if anyone's going to hang around or look fit in terms of how they look with Jabba, he does. And I don't know if it's because of Solo that I've put him on this table, but just an opportunity to show him off to you. And of course you've got Fett. Now this is the one I really want to have on the Khetanna, because as I say, I want to mock up a peacetime cruise. You know, there's no fighting going on, they're just all on there, and Fett would be there. And this is, I want him on the I want him desperately on the deck, just looking down, just keeping an eye, or he could be below decks, but that's the one I want to choose. That's the one they're going to repack in the vintage collection. But also, see the articulated rangefinder there as well. This is another great Fett, and I just thought to take this opportunity to talk to you and show you this one as well. This is the 300th figure Fett that came out in the Power of the Jedi line, but it's sculpted and the articulation is limited, but I tell you what, it just looks so cool, and he might look good in a battle scene, just stood on the top of the Khetanna, you know, on the deck. I love the paint touch-ups on this one. It's a great Fett figure, that. Really good. So anyway, I just thought I'd show you that as well. I couldn't not show you IG-88 since we've been talking about Fett and Bosk, but I know there was a rivalry between Fett and IG-88. I don't know what exactly the problem was. Maybe it was just they were competing against each other to get Han Solo and Carbonite, but I know that he ends up in Bespin or smashed up, or another version of him does. But I don't know if Jabba would rely. I mean, they all managed to stand civilly together in the, you know, with Vader. On the Empire Strikes Back, they're all sort of congregated together, being civil. But I don't know. There's just a link between Jabba and Fett, and then Fett with these other guys. So, yeah, I thought I'd show him as well. Now, moving on, at the back there, I read something the other day about Crimson Dawn, I beg your pardon, that's Dryden Voss's crew. Black Sun, now there are links between Black Sun, the Hutt Clan, Crimson Dawn, they're all underworld gangster syndicates in the Star Wars galaxy, of which you've got Prince Zizor in the background there. I don't see why he wouldn't have ever done a cruise with Jabba. I don't know, it's just all open to interpretation, isn't it? These Imperials, as I say, I love the idea of having a couple just hanging around in the entourage on the cruise. I've chosen sort of, not generic, because these guys are obviously from the Death Star set, but they are the lesser known ones. So I can't imagine someone like Tarkin, you know, cruising with Jabba the Hutt and a load of gangsters. I can't imagine, you know, Piet. I mean, even Admiral Piet refers to bounty hunters as scum. So though the Imperials will have to, you know, work alongside some of these crime lords and have ties with them, even Vader himself knows the name Jabba the Hutt. And he'll know Vader, he'll know Anakin Skywalker knew who Jabba the Hutt was via the pod racing days, so everybody knows who Jabba is. But I just thought that these guys were just sort of non-generic. You might recognise him from A New Hope, as I say, but this is a, you know, he could just be here to protect him, you know, it's a little bit of a, you know, watch his back while he's doing business with Jabba. I can't even speak, I'm so sorry, I need to spit my words out. He is a Death Star trooper without his helmet, so he just looks like an officer. And, you know, generic. This is obviously an engineer, but he might just be, you know, on Tatooine, know him, and they've both gone off on the Jabba to do some business, on the Jabba barge to do business. Whatever. It's just, there you go. Some Imperials, I think it would work nicely. So a mixture of everything there, ladies and gentlemen. Imperials, pod racers, bounty hunters, informers, spies, and friends of Jabba the Hutt. And I like the idea of putting those guys on the barge. So let me know your thoughts. How are you going to display your barge? Are you thinking about doing something like I am? Just a little bit of a hark to the past? I mean, speaking of Han Solo and all of that, these guys have had far too much to drink, they're all falling over. I was thinking about having the young Han Solo maybe on there as well, because, you know, that love that scene in Solo. I keep talking about Solo a lot in this video, but when he says, you know, I'm putting together a crew, some big shot gangster on Tatooine. You in, kid? Whatever he says. Obviously, Han then goes off to Tatooine, and that is blatantly Jabba the Hutt they're talking about, so we would have met Jabba. I'd love the next Solo film to be the Kenobi film. I'd love it to be a story about Jabba, Han, and Kenobi could be involved. And I've had this theory, this is for another video, this, but let me know your thoughts on this. I've got this theory that Han, I don't know if anyone's ever talked about, I don't know if anyone's ever talked about this, but I think that Han could have met Kenobi, and that first scene when they meet each other, there's something about it. It's almost like they know each other or they've heard of each other. He says, Han Solo, Captain of the Millennium Falcon. He goes, you never heard of the Millennium Falcon? You might not have heard of the ship, but it's that bit when he says, you know, fool, I knew you were going to say that. It's almost like they kind of subconsciously know each other. So they might have met briefly, but I like the idea of Kenobi being involved, obviously because it's Jabba the Hutt and he's on Tatooine anyway. Han Solo doing early business with Jabba. Let me know. It could be almost the shipment that he drops. But ever since he's been running from Jabba, I just don't know. Let me know what you think about that. I'd love them to do a Solo part two, but I wouldn't want it to be another Solo movie. It could be Aldrin Irish, whatever his name is, the actor, in it. In a Kenobi film, set on Tatooine, and then you'd see the early days of the Khetanna barge. So that's me just waffling, speaking my mind there, but I will do another video on that at some point in the future, but let me know your thoughts. This has been quite a long video. We're on 18 minutes now on my counter. Longer with the introduction. So anyway, thanks for watching. This has been Only One Kenobi. Only One, out.